What put us on that path? Many experts believe it's our reliance on fossil fuels for transportation and for electric power generation.
The energy mix in the U.S. at the moment is very heavily weighted towards fossil fuels. For electricity, about 50% of our, the raw fuel, the raw energy for it comes from coal. Another percent is natural gas. So, it adds up very quickly that it's overwhelmingly fossil fuels.
The reason gas and coal are relied on so heavily is simple economics, supply and demand.
The United States actually is blessed with some of the most prolific deposits of coal in the entire world. But if you wanted to use those reserves to generate just electricity, there are probably hundreds of years of reserves of coal.
And all that supply means savings for consumers.
The biggest benefit we have by producing coal-fired electricity is that coal is abundant, which means the fuel source is very cost-effective, and that means lower rates for customers in the long run.
Even though fossil fuels are abundant and cost-effective, there is a price to pay. Global climate change, smog, acid rain, these very serious environmental problems all get traced back to burning fossil fuels.
It's very clear that the carbon that's contained in these fossil fuels has contributed to the increase in the concentration of CO2 in the atmosphere. And, it's a measurable, significant increase. Most people think about climate change these days, but probably the more immediate problems really have to do with acid rain that's formed from sulfur that's in the fossil fuels that we use.
According to the Environmental Protection Agency, about two-thirds of all sulfur emissions come from electric power generation. One way to lower fossil fuels' environmental price tag is through technology.
One of the most promising parts of clean coal technology is the idea that you would take the coal and actually take the chemical components in it in a relatively simple reaction and make them into gases. And then once you have a gas, we know a lot of ways to actually make combustion of gases very clean, very efficient.
Developing these cleaner burning technologies could keep fossil fuels in the energy mix for the future. But EPRI foresees a trend away from fossil fuels.
We need to basically accelerate the move away from fossil fuels. It's happening. We're about halfway through a 300-year trend in decarbonizing the total energy system. So we're heading in the right direction, but we may not be moving fast enough.
Remember that collision course with the environment? Of course, there are other options for generating electricity.
Electricity allows you to diversify fuels. It's one of the advantages of electricity, is that you can take advantage of the sun, you can take advantage of the wind, you can take advantage of the splitting of atoms, nuclear power. So it allows you to diversify energy, and that's really where energy is going, into a very diversified portfolio of sources.
These diverse sources all have benefits and drawbacks, just like fossil fuels. As we look at the other options to generate electricity, keep some questions in mind. Is the resource abundant? Is it available? Is it cost-effective? And what are the environmental outcomes of using the energy source? Let's explore more about the future of energy.